Hi, this is TapCat, and welcome to part 15 of Let's Play XCOM 2. Since I saw you last, I did reshuffle my engineers just a little bit. I pulled an engineer off of the Advanced Warfare Center because we don't need sped up healing anymore. Everybody's healthy. And moved them down here. So this should be done sooner. And then the other thing that I want to do is come in here and let's go ahead and put another soldier in for training. I have two rangers and I'm thinking we could use a third, and then I'll probably start either another grenadier or another specialist later, but let's go ahead and do this. And of course, we can always recruit more rookies. My recent experiences being solo on soldiers has made me, you know, a little skittish about our situation. So we decided last time that we would go to East Asia and protect whatever this device is. I feel like we have to prevent this. And we could use another scientist. There's a lot of technologies that would help us right now. And it's going to take real time to, you know, research plasma weapons and powered armor and stuff. Admittedly, pretty much all of the rewards would be good for us if you get down to it. But, all right, so let me do this. I want to bring him for sure. And I want to bring him for sure. I am less confident about the need for her. And yep, you too. So I'm happy to bring this guy, but I think, okay, hold on, let me do this. So we'll bring Django. He's been on the shelf for a long time, and then I'll bring the lower level sharpshooter. What I want to do is get a mix of higher level, you know, kind of high, medium, and low. And I think I'm kind of nervous about bringing Julie, like just having both of these guys. Yeah, you know what, I'll leave her out. We're bringing this guy. Three grenadiers is probably a little much. So I want Felipe. So there's only one other spot, and I've only got one captain and one lieutenant. So I guess what I need to do is pick between Abby and my sharpshooter, and I think I'll bring Abby. She's got some pretty good abilities, you know, with combat protocol and her hacking and stuff. So we've got the mimic beacon. I see. Let me do this, though. I need to... stop it. Actually, let me just do that. And then come in here with her. Because, realistically, I need to not have the med kit on her. I need it on him, because he's the one who's now going to get multiple charges out of it. Okay, so she's got that. And nobody has the acid grenade at this time. You know what? I don't want him... okay, there we go. I don't want him to have the Talon rounds. I don't... Yeah, so we'll just come here. Okay. So, acid grenade. Who's going to take it? Him, maybe? Can he do that? No. I thought he could. Yep, okay. The way they do the grenades is a little funky. I'll go ahead and give him the stupid nano vest. I'm afraid its best days are behind it as far as the impact it has. But I think we're good to go.
Ranger deployed.
We're in the pipe. 5x5.
Apparently the Resistance has been relying on an old data tap along the Advent network that had, up until this point, been eluding the aliens' detection. Recent intel suggests the data the Resistance found is critical to the aliens' latest operation. Unfortunately, Advent is already moving to take out the device, and we can't let that happen. Eliminate all hostile contacts and secure the area. Protect that device at all costs. Hostile forces are already moving to destroy the data tap installed nearby. We need to lock down the area and secure the device at all costs.
All right, so we don't have to worry about the number of turns. That's kind of a nice change. Can't go through the window, or we're going to set off all the alarms. I very much want to avoid losing our concealment, you know, for as long as possible. Now, what I will do, I'm not going to go too close to the edge of the roof, but I'm going to assume there's no aliens literally on that roof, and that's the only way I would break concealment that I know of. Okay. That was actually closer than I wanted it to be to losing concealment. So there's no entrances in the front of this place that I can use. I'd have to come all the way over here. And if I did, what would that do for me? There's no windows. Okay, all the way over here. I could use this door, and then I could come here. What I'm trying to do is figure out how I can get more angles of attack on these guys. That's all. I want flanking shots. And I don't want them to have a lot of good options of places that they can go to, elude us. I'm actually a little concerned about where I put him now. I feel like he could potentially be flanked with that spot there open. This gap. Hopefully not. Now, I did just block roof access. I don't know if that was smart or not. I guess I don't I don't dare go through that door. I'm terrified we'll trip them. Let me do this. Let me bring her here. Okay. This may be foolish, but I feel like getting somebody, you know, back there could be really useful. Running. To come at them from the other side. Admittedly, when you split your squad, it can also get somebody dead. All right. I certainly don't expect to need Overwatch unless they spot my Ranger. That was funny the way they kind of ran like that. All right. So this is a lot less good now. I can't tell if they're just going to go this way. I don't know if this was worthwhile. However, I have started down this road, and I intend to see where it leads.
I'm on the move.
Okay. So I think I'll move him. I see. He wants to go through windows. So what if I bring him here and then I'll go in? That's fine. Rolling. If there's a way you can make them change their route, I don't know what that is. Yeah, see, I'd like to come over... Well, I don't have the movement points to do it, so... Oh, I had it. Ugh! It keeps bolting away from me. There, that's it. Moving out. Not through the window! Oh my god, when he jumped down there, I thought he was going to do it. Yeah, so we have decent shots at a couple of these guys, but obviously what I'd like to do is... I got to be careful going too far over that way, don't I? I do not want to reveal another group right now. Okay. Headed there now. And then... I got to be really careful with him. I think I'm just going to end up hunkering down with him. I would like... Yeah. I'll come here in two steps. Now, hopefully I'm not being too aggressive here. Okay. All right, so... We are decently dispersed. I think the, Oh my god, no. Sorry, wrong button. The biggest thing is that I peeled those other two guys off. And so, if I need to start shooting and they're not here yet, then obviously that would be bad. And I think I may well have made a mistake on that front. Because, as you can see, I have to go quite a ways... Now, I could bring them here, but this doesn't really do me any good this turn. I'm seriously thinking that maybe I should just start the fight now, because we would have these guys pretty badly flanked. And then we can move them forward based on what happens. Yeah, I would want to lead the fight with him. Interesting question. Do I start with him or the mech? All right. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to lead the fight with him, launching an acid grenade on all three of these guys. So, Overwatch. Not you. Overwatch.
Affirmative. Covering now.
And Overwatch.
Overwatch.
Okay. Launch acid grenade. It's so rare I get three people with one grenade. Honestly, it's pretty rare I get two. So... I'm pretty happy about that. One downside to what I'm doing is I was going to say he could be flanked, but actually now that I look, I don't think that's true. But if I waited another turn, it would be. Come on, you can do it. Okay. Mech down. Hang on. Did my ranger not fire? That seems strange. Let me move Abby up. She could possibly have a shot. She does, and it's a good one, so I am going to take it. Beautiful. So two of the three are dead. I'm feeling good about my choice, by and large. And then, I guess there's no point doing this yet. I'll wait, but... Oh, he's the only one who can move. Okay, never mind. Everybody else is on Overwatch, so... Yeah, that's the only move I have left. Right, he's still taking acid burn. Well, now I'm going to get flanked. Oh, right, right. I don't have to worry about flanking with this guy. Works a little differently.
I'll just go do that then.
Poor Django. Do I want to give Django this kill? Actually, you know who I really want to give the kill to, if I can, is him. He has a 68% chance to hit, which is not great. And it doesn't look to me like I'm going to get super close. I am going to come out of cover because I just can't really see how this is going to come back to haunt me this turn. That improves his chances a bit. Let's go ahead and take the shot. Good, cool. He's the only one of the squaddies we didn't get promoted last time. And obviously, I would like to rectify that now. Let's have Felipe pick up the goodies. And I hope they are good. A repeater. Okay.
Got it.
That's not going to be great. When they have like advanced repeater or adjectives like that, that's definitely a lot better. I'll go ahead and reload them. Get back up to full. You know what I just realized, though, is that I've been kind of treating this like time was not important. And I don't think that's true, because they could, in fact, start attacking the device. I think that's at least possible. So we are, I think, going to need to start rolling out. And you know what I have to be careful of is going through that stupid acid. I left a bit of a toxic waste dump behind myself. I believe we have a path, though, so it should be okay. I'll bring her out here, and I'll go ahead and reload her as well. So we're no longer concealed, but I definitely cannot complain about how that fight went. I mean, that was pretty much exactly what I wanted. Oh, crap. Well, oh, they're not active? Right, because he never fired. He's still concealed. So if they don't move any closer, and I sure hope they don't. Nope, they're gonna. They're on patrol. Now, I'm okay being exposed because they won't fire right now. And I'm talking about my Grenadier. He's in kind of a tough spot, but we're going to work that out. So now, obviously I'm not going to leave him where he's at. And in a funny way, I kind of feel like this is not the worst. Because I can move him up. Yes, I said it. Actually, I shouldn't have moved him here though. Now that I think about it. Okay. So if I do that, they will both get hit. I'm good with that. Okay. Plasma grenades. I think that's my very first plasma grenade that I've launched, and I have to say, I kind of like it. Kind of sexy. Okay, so he can't hit for crap from where he is. And Felipe is going to have a hard time. I'll come up here. I need to think about this. Before I do him, Abby and my Ranger, Paladin, they by far have the best positions here, right? Wow, it's a shame she can't come here. That's such a perfect spot. So if I want to flank this guy straight up and be protected myself. Oh no, she is protected. Wow, she has a crappy shot. Oh, but of course, because he's got full cover from her. Okay, I tell you what we're going to do. I'm going to go after the Viper. 85%. I think this is reasonable. So the question in my mind now is, you know, is it worth using a grenade on this guy to break his cover and stuff? Because I just don't have, like, he can easily kill this guy. Who else could kill either one of them? This is tough. Okay, how many soldiers do I have? I have Felipe. I have Mike, who is not yet moved. Maybe I'll come up here. Let's do that.
Position confirmed.
I'm not standing where he is. Not in this situation. Now, he can only use his stupid pistol. So if I shoot at this guy, I'm wounding him and probably not that badly. I have 0% chance to crit. So that's fine. I'll do that. But, well, somebody's going to have to shoot. And I think in this case, I'm going to use Felipe on this guy. It's a semi-reasonable shot. Yeah, and if he hits it, see, now all of a sudden, our options are looking way better because Mike's shot is potentially lethal. If he hits... Oh, that's so cheap. So cheap. I love it. Abby hasn't... Oh, I did. I used Abby. So, only these two. All right, well, look. I feel like this guy, he's just too powerful. I have to get rid of him. So, he's done.
Well, how about that?
And now I have a choice. I can... Oh... Well, oh, I get a free move. Okay. So now what I could do is suppress the Viper. Or I could use his last grenade. I think I'll suppress it.
Bring the pipe.
I think that will stop. Yeah, and then I'll pull him back. Although he could still flank some of my other guys. But I have a feeling he's going to pull back. Never mind, he's dead. Suppression worked very well. I'm very happy. All right, so we will move forward and reload. We'll overload is what we'll do. And I will go ahead and move forward. I know I got caught out of cover, but it didn't actually matter, to be honest.
Ready to engage.
Okay. And Felipe, I'll bring you here. I'm not going to be completely ridiculous about cover when there's some near where we want to be. I don't really want to move forward of that area. I think I'll just leave him where he's at on Overwatch. Abby can move here.
I'm on the move.
But again, we're going to stay close to the others.
Ready to go.
And yeah. He could move up, but it doesn't make sense to. If I reveal a group right now, are they firing at the thing? They sure are. All right, well, that's what I was saying. And I have kind of taken my time. Oh, crap. So this is problematic because what I wanted to do is get moving, and wow, we have a trouble now. We got big trouble.
Heading out.
Well, I tell you what we're going to do.
I'm on it.
I intend to get very, very close to the reinforcements that are coming in. And go on overwatch so that when they land, they are really going to be hurting. I'll leave him on overwatch.
Scanning.
Now, I'm not going to do that with everybody. I think these... How many is that? Four? Hang on. Where's my other... There's these two. I'm missing somebody. Where's Django? Oh, that's right. I moved him here. I'm thinking these two are going to move forward.
On the way.
I got to at least try and draw some attention. That's really dangerous. Oh, boy. And we'll go on overwatch too, so we may still hit them, the reinforcements. I just want to start moving somebody towards that device because we could easily fail this mission. And that would kind of defeat the point of why we chose it, wouldn't it?
Advent troops here.
All right, guys. Guys. Stage fright? There you go. I think we got a dead mech.
X-ray neutralized. Target down.
Is anybody alive? Of theirs, I mean. Stop hitting it. Okay. One guy has one health. All right, let's do this. Where is he? He come in here. So he can, but he can't flank him. I don't want to use up any more soldiers here than I have to. So I'm going to bring Mike down. And I mean, I want to get this guy promoted too. I want a decent gunslinger. And right now, I mean, he's not that. So this should be a guaranteed kill. Yep, execution style. So now the rest of us can just start moving. And that's kind of what I'm looking for. And by kind of, I mean exactly.
We're close.
Yep.
Menace 1-5, we've got a line on the target. Move to protect that gear at all costs.
Well, I'm trying, Bubba. I am trying. So the others can't see it. That's plain enough.
Position confirmed.
The question is, should I start dashing here? I definitely don't have, you know, a lot of time. And I'd just soon not get killed. What if I bring her... Hey, this is rough. They always know where you've gone. That's one thing that is a little scary. But I'm really tempted to use these roofs. If I can just say that.
I can handle that.
Although I don't like the half cover. Okay, I'm not... There we go. So I'll come here. I don't think I'm going to get flanked. Oh, hell. Well, they can see him. I thought I was far enough back on the roof that that would not happen. So, yeah, I did not think anyone could have the angle to see him. But they do. So that's great. So hold on. Django actually can see one of these guys. And I think what I'll do, I actually have a chance to just kill him straight up, or I could suppress him. I think I'm going to take the chance here and try to kill him. All right. It didn't work out. Oh, I got two damage even though I missed. So that's something I forgot to say. I did a couple of weapon upgrades off camera. So that is why he got that. It just takes so long filtering through it all. What I should have done, though, is said that at the beginning of the session. So I apologize. Let's just move him forward. So I, up until now, was doing really well. And now I feel like there's a very good chance I'm going to get my ranger killed.
Move.
So we'll see how that goes. You know, and I mean, there's just only so much I can do because these guys are so far behind. Yeah, you know what I just realized too is I should have used aid protocol. So, all right, well, at least he's shooting at somebody else. If shooting is the right word.
Who's got a med kit?
I'm actually not feeling too bad about this so far. Okay, this is bad. All right. So I'm going to get lucky. And that's what it is. Okay, so if I bring him here, he can certainly take a shot. And I don't see any reason not to. Boy, for some reason, my mouse cursor is just really twitchy. It doesn't want to give me, you know, the location to go to. And that dodge gets frickin' old. Okay, I know Django can shoot that thing, but what I want to do, if possible, is hit him with Felipe instead. Nope. Because Django is one who would have been very effective against the guys outside. And, I could have used that, but unfortunately now I'm not going to be able to do it. So the mouton gets to fire at him, and yeah, that's not good. But obviously I can't leave this guy alive. Man, I tell you, their dodge ability, it's pretty wicked. Pretty wicked. And kind of lost track of which way he needed to go. Yeah, get your move. Your butt moving, Mike. Yeah, I feel like I managed the early encounters very well, and I feel like I have managed this one very poorly. At least, you know, I started it very poorly. I misjudged. I should have moved him here. And I wanted to make sure I could come up here, you know, on the next turn. And I thought that I was far enough back that that would be okay. And it wasn't, so. Okay, it didn't work out very well. I think she had a 90% chance, but. Now, this is actually pretty awkward. What I really want is for somebody to heal him. I'm really tempted to come up here for this turn. We are not killing these guys or making significant progress on killing them. Because he would have been the only one who could shoot at either one. And he only has 4 health. I'm going to try to get Felipe to heal him next turn. I'm very worried about Django here. Oh, he's shooting at the device. Okay. That's actually good because the device has a decent amount of health left. Okay. He went after Abby and missed. Yep, I thought that was the grab. Okay, so now what I need to do... I can't see for crap. So there's no cover there, and there's half cover here. Can the guys back here... First of all, let me do this. Gremlin heal. Can he... Yes, he can. So I'm going to do this.
Healer mode.
I want to make sure we keep him alive. And honestly, if I could, I'd probably just heal Django next. Really irritated that I got him hurt this badly. Okay. Yeah, I actually could do that. That's pretty funny. 60%. Well, I don't want to catch her on fire, but she can flank the mouton. And she has, but she has a plasma grenade. I guess if I want the plasma grenade, I can just throw it, right? I feel like if anything, I almost have too many options this turn. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to run and gun with him. And I'm going to come here. And I'm going to take a shotgun whack at this guy. Yep.
Impressed yet?
And then... I'm going to hold that move. I'm assuming I can't... Oh, I can. Wow. Well, then why not? Honestly. Let's get rid of his armor, do a bunch of damage. I don't know if plasma will actually make the car explode right now. That would be amazing. It did. It freaking did. That is sick.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Okay. So I did one really stupid thing. And now my Ranger is going to be hurt for a long time. As far as Django, that's a little different. I mean, he got tongue grabbed. I don't know that I could have really avoided that very easily. But if I had managed the beginning of that encounter better, then maybe I could have arranged it so that, you know, fewer aliens were alive to take shots in the first place. Because basically I gave them one turn of all three taking shots at me. And then I think there were at least 2 turns. You're going to get hurt that way. You have to position yourself so that that doesn't happen, if at all possible. So I let the pressure of getting to that machine quickly get to me. I should have just moved a little slower, a little more carefully. And so I will try to absorb that lesson for next time. The good news is we do have three promotions. I know I haven't taken anyone with blast padding, and I'm not going to start now. And then Felipe. So I said all along he's going to be my healer. Haywire is nice, but I don't use it hardly ever. And I'm just going to keep down the medic path. And then it's nice to see Abby get a promotion. She's now my highest ranking officer. And I am going to take Guardian here, I think. If you spend all of your actions on moves, you're granted an automatic Overwatch at the end of the turn. That's pretty interesting, but I think I like this one better. I don't know, though. That one's interesting when you need to cover a lot of ground fast. That might actually be a better ability. You know, I'm thinking about it kind of after the fact. Okay.
Oh, Commander.
So, we got our scientist. And that'll speed up our research a bit. And I'm afraid to look, but let's see. Let's see how bad it is. 21 days. Yay. But that is on the assumption. Okay, I just left here. Why does it keep doing that? I don't know if I'm clicking something wrong, but I come out here, and last episode did the same thing. It just pulled me immediately right back into that. So I am going to empty out one of my science or engineer slots here and put it to work on the heels. So now we should have succeeded in significantly cutting that. Yep, 11 days and 3 days. All right, I can live with that. I am miffed that I made that kind of mistake, but it is what it is. Let's try to get these alloys again. If we can. Granted, I'm not like super low on alloys, but nonetheless.
Strategic resource located.
24? Wow. I don't feel like that's a good reward for 5 days. Huh, 7 days. I don't like that. I'd actually rather come here. I want to build our facilities quicker so I can do the radio thing and just get our
I've made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
I'll talk about it in a minute. Okay, so let's see. What does all this boil down to? I don't really. Okay, we can build the shadow chamber. Fair enough. This facility will allow Dr. Tigan and Chief Shen to conduct highly specialized projects to decrypt the aliens' most valuable secrets. So now, what do we want to research? Psionics? Because I've kind of been putting that off. We've had it for a while. What does this do? We could make our armor a little better. 3 days, that's not terrible. I'll be able to mirror. This could make weapons a little better. I think, this opens up proving ground projects. And I think what I'd rather do is just go after the plasma rifle.
I had assumed you'd make that research a priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Okay. Okay, that's good news. I don't remember. Laboratory power defense matrix repurposes recovered advent turrets as automated defenses to be deployed in the case of a ground assault on the Avenger. I see. Okay, I need to see which room this is. Yes, okay, this is the one that I want to build the resistance comms in. 110 supplies, 3 power, 8 days. They'll do it.
Facility construction initiated.
Yes. All right, so that's what we need before we can go to that next area and start trying to get the stupid, next black site attacked. So I'm going to keep doing this. All right. Carry on. Do I want to assign someone else? I guess so. I hate to keep coming in and out of this screen.
Commander, I appreciate you recruiting new staff for the engineering team.
Oh.
But as it stands, we have people still waiting for an assignment.
Okay.
We can have them working on construction, excavation, or staffing a facility.
Okay. So, I was going to go here. We have one more soldier that we can start training. Wait, I just did this wrong. I don't know why, but this is what I want to do. Come on. Yes. All right. I just want another grenadier. Because for most missions, I want 2. And if 2 get hurt, I'm down to 1. So this one will probably never get as high as the others, but whatever. Oh, the Skulljack's complete. Okay. So now I got to come back out. This is what I was saying. What's kind of driving me crazy in the game is that I have to keep coming in and out of this screen. And it's very frustrating. Like, you get 2 seconds of scanning in. Oh, let me come out and do this now. And, but you have to. Otherwise, you're wasting valuable time in here. So what is skull mining? Tigan has conceived of a more thorough means of extracting information from Advent soldiers' chips. This new skull mining technique could lead to new intel gains from our enemies and could even grant access to hidden alien facilities for the purpose of sabotage. I can also upgrade our Skulljacks to significantly enhance the hacking ability of any soldier carrying one. Well, that's awfully good. Battlefield medicine would be very welcome too. And you know what? I kind of want to do that first. But I won't. Oh, wait. Didn't I already do this? I get it. So that's, I only have 1 Skulljack. I'd like to do some of these other things too. But I'll do skull mining. God, 75 supplies. You're killing me, you guys. You're killing me. What's my intel up to? 149. So now I have to come out again, and I'm not going to do anything to this, but I have an engineer who's now free. So I'll start them clearing crap out, I guess. I don't see any reason not to. Brother, I actually have 2. Come on. There we go. Okay. Now, Lino, let's go back to this map. how far am I from... God, what am I even trying to do? Building the thing. Whatever. Resistance comms. Oh, okay. All right. We have something to do now. We are going to go and try to stop an Advent retaliation. So when we come back, that's what we'll do. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. I hope we see you next time.